top story. Life in prison without the possibility of parole. That is the sentence for Melissa Huckabee. The former Sunday school teacher spoke for the first time today. Joe Vasquez was in Stockton for this sentencing with actually new details about the killer and the killing emerged. Joe.
Juliet, it was an intensely emotional scene up in the courtroom this morning. As you mentioned, Melissa Huckabee spoke for the first time and admitted to the crime. Also, some of Sandra Cantu's family members spoke. At one point, it seemed like half the courtroom was in tears. The judge lifted the gag order, so we're starting to learn a few details about the murder as well as the sexual assault. Now, what we want to tell our viewers is that we're not going to get into the details of the sexual assault because we just don't feel it's appropriate right now during this program. But we will say that Melissa Huckabee denied those allegations.
Not have taken Sandra from you. And I want you to know that she did not suffer and I did not sexually molest her daughter. I would also like to apologize to Sandra's extended family. I know that it caused you a great deal of grief, and for that I am truly sorry.
Ever since Sandra's body was found in a suitcase last March, we have never known what killed her. A gag order has kept all information out of the public eye. But today, as Melissa Huckabee learned she will serve life in prison without the possibility of parole, the district attorney's office began to lay out the details of the murder. The DA says after Sandra Cantu's body was found in a suitcase in the pond, the pathologist examined her body and found she died of asphyxiation. The DA says there was a bloody cloth tied around Sandra's head in a noose, that she had a powerful drug in her system called benzodiazepine. That's a generic term for Xanax, a medicine generally prescribed for anxiety. Prosecutors also say they found more evidence inside the Clover Road Baptist Church. A cord from the blinds was used to tie the suitcase shut. We're also now learning a witness placed Huckabee at the scene of the crime. Prosecutors say a retired U.S. Marine and his wife saw Huckabee at the pond that day. She told them she had just stopped to urinate.
In my heart, I should hate or anything like that. You took the life of an innocent little girl. Ain't nothing you do in life ever gonna change anything.
Sandra Cantu's father, you know, her aunt also took the stand. She spoke before the court, and she played a video of Sandra Cantu's short life. That's when nearly the entire courtroom, frankly, dissolved into tears. Juliet, very emotional moment and punctuated by these new details that, you know what, the family didn't want made public, but the court has decided to make them public.
Yeah, I don't think any of us can forget that image of her skipping, that little girl skipping. So sad. All right, Joe Vasquez. Joe,
exactly.
Thank you.